what you need to know about the AMD Ryzen 9 9950X 3D. It has 16 Zen 5 cores and 32 threads, base clock speed at 4.3 GHz and a maximum boost clock at 5.7 GHz. AMD has re-engineered its on-chip memory solution with second generation 3D VCache technology. The 128 MB cache memory has been relocated below the processor, bringing the core complex dies, CCDs, closer to the cooling solution to help keep the Zen 5 cores cooler. It's the strongest X3D processor and it is fully unlocked. MSRP is set at $699, so there is a significant price gap from the 9950X currently sold at $550. According to AMD's test data on 40 games, it achieves an average of 8% higher FPS at full HD than the 7950X3D. On the same games, AMD states that it is 20% faster than the Intel Core i9-285K. It is within 1% of the average game performance of 9800X3D. I use an ASRock Tai Chi X870E and an RTX 5090 in my test system. RAM is by G-Skill with Hynix ICs running at 6000 megatransfers per second. The cooler is an Octo D15 G2 LBC. Forza Motorsport, large improvement. Resident Evil 4, large improvement. Assassin's Creed Mirage, high enough improvement. Cyberpunk, notable improvement. Ratchet and Clank, small improvement. Black Myth Wukong, tiny improvement. Power consumption is hugely increased compared to the 7950X3D processor, which officially has a 50 watt lower TDP. It is similar to the 9950X. The peak power consumption is similar to that of the 9950X, but much higher than that of the 7950X3D. Remember that in this chart I also include the mainboard's VRM losses, since I don't measure directly at the CPU socket but on the PSU's cable outputs. Nonetheless, you need to know the power that your PSU has to deliver in real life, and these results show the differences between the processors in terms of power consumption requirements. The 9950X3D is more efficient than the 9950X and efficient in general, but not as efficient as the 7950X3D. The maximum operating temperature in Blender is not that high for an AMD processor at 81.4 degrees Celsius. Still, I should note that I used the high-end Noctua air cooler in my test system, which is probably the highest performance air cooling solution available today. That said, the new design of the AL3 CAS, which is now under the CCD, allowing for the direct contact with a head spreader, vastly improves thermals. The relative performance of the 9950X3D is higher than that of the 9950X and notably higher than that of the 7950X3D, but its price at $700 makes it perform less well in performance per price. If AMD decides to lower its price notably, say by $100, it will make it much more competitive. For reference, at the time of the review, the 9950X was sold at around $550 and I used a similar price for the 7950X3D to form the performance per price graph. Without gaming in the way, the performance gap between the 9950X3D and the 9950X gets smaller. Still, the performance gap with the 7950X3D gets larger. In the performance per price chart, the 9950X3D scores last because of its increased MSRP. In gaming, the 9950X3D takes first place, followed by the 7950X3D. AMD spoke of an 8% difference in gaming performance between these two processors in 40 games, and I found 7.1% in 6 titles, so AMD's claims seem to stand. In its results, though, AMD didn't mention the massive gap in performance per watt, with the 7950 XT having a tremendous lead. Unfortunately, I couldn't include the 9800 XT in the charts because the processor I bought from Amazon was fake, and there was no time to get a new one in time. At the time of this review, the single 9800 XT I have is occupied in my GPU test system. Moreover, you only found 3 entries in my charts because I decided to fully reset the corresponding information in every major CPU or GPU release to include only the most recent results obtained with the most recent drivers, Windows, game and application updates. Given that we typically receive the new hardware several days before the official release, this is my case at least, this means that I can only retest a limited number of parts, so I carefully select them. Nonetheless, I prefer to provide a smaller but highly accurate comparison set. The Ryzen 9 9950 XT fulfills AMD's promise of improved gaming performance compared to the previous generation flagship, the 7950 XT. Besides a 7.1% gaming performance improvement, there is close to 11% improvement on all CPU tasks, gaming included, and an 11.7% improvement on all tasks but gaming. You have to be careful with core parking when it comes to gaming at low resolutions because you only need the cores with the L3 cache to handle the games and not all of them. In most cases, this goes well. But if you make the mistake of using the legacy control panel to change or customize the power plan, you will disable this feature. You must go to Windows Settings, System, Power, and make any desired power plan changes, or code parking won't work. This is a small detail, but you have to keep it in mind. It is highly advised to have the most recent AMD drivers, BIOS version, and the latest version of the game bar application. In a single case, I noticed that the wrong cores were packed, and the CPU used the ones without the extra cache. So, to solve this, I had to completely remove all AMD drivers and install them again after a reboot to fix the issue. Generally, if you play at full HD using a strong GPU, you must check if core parking works as intended or you might lose performance. This is why most hardcore gamers prefer the 9800 XT, which only has a single CCD, so it doesn't have such issues. The performance per watt tells a completely different story from the relative performance. Here, the dead low gaming power consumption of the 7950 XT provides a strong advantage. The difference gets lower in the other two sections, but it is still notable. I guess this is why AMD didn't include any performance per watt scores in its reviewer guide. Nonetheless, the 50 watt TDP increase of the 9950 XT over its predecessor shows increased power consumption. However, this doesn't affect the operating temperatures because of the better contact of the CCDs with the head speeder. This is what most likely allowed the TDP to increase and also allowed AMD to provide a direct overclocking option. The 9950 XT is a fine processor, not only for gaming, but for everything. It aims at users who need strong gaming performance without any compromises in tasks that require more than 8 cores. If only its price were lower. Hopefully AMD will drop its price close to $600 at some point, because currently at $700 it is way too expensive compared to the 9950X. Hope you liked the review. Please subscribe to our channel, and till the next time. Bye bye.